In this video, you will learn about three ways to make $100 a day.
Welcome to the Trading with Venus podcast, where we help you establish strong trading habits, generate consistent profits, and create the lifestyle you desire for yourself and your family. Now your host, Raman Gill.
Hi, this is Raman. Welcome to another episode of the Trading with Venus podcast. Today, we'll look at three ways that you can make $100 a day. Why $100? Because when most people start, $100 a day is the first benchmark they want to reach. And of course, I started the same way as well. I wanted to make $100 a day. I remember I went to a course a long time ago, and I was talking to one of my fellow students at this Forex course, and they were asking about the goals. Funnily enough, both of our goals was to make $100 a day, because that, like I said, is the first benchmark. That's why I wanted to share with you how you can make $100 a day. Now, when we are trading Forex, there are so many different strategies and so many different ways to make money. A lot of times, people will argue about what is the best strategy or what's the best way to make money. However, let me tell you, after all these years in trading Forex, what I have learned is that there is no holy grail. There are so many different strategies, and there are many, many, many different ways to make money. Like they say, there are many ways to skin the cat, and that is true for Forex as well. Today, we'll take a look at three of these ways. The most important thing you want to understand is that pick a strategy and work on that strategy. It's more important to master a strategy than having 100 different strategies. You don't need 100 different tools in your tool belt unless you are a professional contractor. For us, unless you're a professional trader, you don't need 20 different strategies or 100 different strategies. You just need two or three different strategies, and you just need to understand what markets they apply in. Not every strategy will work under every market condition. So one, you need to pick two or three strategies, master them, and understand what market conditions they work best under. Then all we have to do is look for what the market condition is, pick the right strategy for that market condition, and of course, getting to the $100 will be easy. So let's go on to the charts, and I will show you three different strategies that I love trading. First one is one of my favorites, the pivot point trading strategy. I love pivot points because they are easy. They are objective targets, unlike Fibonacci, which you can draw anywhere. Pivot points only are at certain points. So every single day they will get marked on your charts, and then all we have to do is look for our trades around those areas. So we'll go on to the chart and look at this strategy in more depth. Here we're looking at a pivot point trade setup. This is Pound Cat 1 hour chart. In a pivot point trade setup, we are looking for price to bounce off of one of the pivot point levels. This can be our daily pivot point or one of the other pivot point levels like R1, R2, S1, S2. When trading pivot points, we know that when price is trending, so let's say the price is trending upwards like we see here. Generally, what happens when price is trending upwards is that we'll see price come into our daily pivot point and then bounce off of that. And the following day as well, we see the same thing, price pulls back into the daily pivot point and then bounces off and so on. So the trend continues like that. So in this case, we see that price has been moving higher. It then pulls into our daily pivot point level, which is our green line here. And then we get this confirmation candle. Once we get this nice bullish candle here, we can enter the trade long because we're looking for price to go higher as it's holding above our daily pivot level. So we enter the trade long and we stay with the trade for as long as price is moving higher. And then we see when it comes to our R2 pivot point level, it starts to go sideways. So for 4 hours here, price is not able to move higher. So this is a good place for us to exit the trade because now price can start to move down. This is our bearish engulfing candle, which is our reversal pattern in opposite direction. So that's why we want to exit the trade. From entry to exit here, we get 85 pips in the trade. So just to recap, in a pivot point trade setup, we're looking for price to bounce off of one of the pivot point levels. So this can be our daily pivot point level in the middle here, or S1, S2, S3, R1, R2, R3, and so forth. In this case, we see that price has been moving higher. It's in an uptrend. It comes into our daily pivot point levels. And once we get this nice bullish candle here, we can enter the trade long because this is our confirmation candle and this shows that momentum is still to the upside and price is likely to go higher. So we enter the trade long here. Our stop can go on the other side of our S1 level here. So we can either place it here or you can place it right below this one. I like to give my trade some room to breathe, so I just put it below our S1 level. And now we're looking for price to go through towards R1 and then R2 level. And we see price moves up higher. And once it gets into this R2 level, we start to see a reversal pattern. So this is a good time for us to exit our trade after this bearish engulfing candle. So we exit the trade here. From entry to exit, we get 85 pips in our trade. So our profit is 85 pips or $850 if trading one standard lot. So that was the pivot point trading strategy. If you like that strategy, click on the link below and you can buy my pivot point course. It's a simple course that takes you through the different steps you need to understand the pivot point strategy. Now, we only looked at a small part of the pivot point strategies. There are other ways that you can use pivot points. So if you want to learn more about it, you can click on the link below and that will take you to the course. The next strategy that we want to look at is Heiken Ashi. Now, Heiken Ashi candlesticks are slightly different than our normal candlesticks because they are averaged. And because they are averaged, they are very good at showing us where the trend is. So if you're somebody who wants something real simple to apply, where you can see the trends clearly, Heiken Ashi candlesticks will be the best ones for you to trade. So let's go on to the charts and I'll show you how the Heiken Ashi candlestick strategy works. Here we are looking at a Heiken Ashi trade setup. This is New Zealand US dollar 15 minute chart. Heiken Ashi candles are good candles to trade just because they smooth out the price action and it's easier to see a trend in when using Heiken Ashi candles. So in this case, here we see that price had been going up. It's just been going sideways for a little bit here. And once it comes into this pivot point level, our daily pivot point level, we see this nice bearish engulfing candle close here. So that's a good place for us to enter the trade short. So we're looking for price to drop here. One of the things about pivot points is that when price holds below the daily pivot, chances are it's going to go down and then we get a nice candle close to go with that. So this is a good setup here to enter the trade short. So we enter the trade here. I like to put my stop on the top of this high. So we want to make sure that price has some room to breathe just in case it decides to come and test this level once again. So I put my stop a little above that level. So once we enter the trade short here, we'll stay with the trade and we see that price drops and then it starts to go sideways here. So we get this kind of like a rounded bottom thing going on. So this is a good place for us to exit the trade. From entry to exit here, we get 55 pips in the trade. So just to recap, we are looking at a Heiken Ashi trade setup and we see price has been going sideways here. Then we get a good solid bearish engulfing candle close right below our daily pivot point. This shows us that price is likely to go lower. So we enter the trade short at the close of this candle and we wait for price to drop. And as it drops, we stay with the trade. Or when it flattens out here, we exit the trade. From entry to exit here, we get 55 pips in our trade. So our profit is 55 pips or $550 when trading one standard lot. That was Heiken Ashi strategy. Now let's move on to our third strategy, which is again one of my favorite ones. And that's because there is only one candlestick that we need to worry about. This strategy is so simple that you can learn it within minutes. And that is my Pinbar strategy. So Pinbar is a candlestick that shows us rejection from support or resistance area. In this case, we are looking for price to move in the opposite direction. So this is a reversal signal. Let's go on to the charts and we'll take a look at what pinbar strategy looks like, and I'll walk you through the process. Here we are looking at a bearish pinbar trade setup. This is dollar CAD 1 hour chart. A bearish pinbar is where we have this single candle here with a large pin on the top and a small candle body. So this is what we are looking for. We want the pin to be larger than the size of the candle body here, like we see in this candle. This gives us our pinbar trade setup. Once we see this formation and we're looking for this at support and resistance level. So in this case, we see price comes into this support resistance level and then we get this bearish pin bar. So this is a bearish reversal signal and we're looking for price to drop after this. Once the candle closes here, we can enter the trade short and our stop would go above this high here. We just want to make sure that trade has enough room to breathe. And then we stay with the trade as price drops, and here price picks up speed, but then we see that price starts to pull back. So this is a good place for us to exit the trade. From entry to exit here, we get 120 pips in our trade. So just to recap here, a bearish pinbar trade setup is a single candlestick setup where we have a large wick on the candle and a small candle body, which is generally red. Once we get the signal, this is a bearish reversal signal, so now we are looking for price to drop. We enter our trade short at the close of this candle, and our stop would go on the other side of this high here. We just want to make sure there's enough room for trade to breathe in case price pulls back before it drops. As price drops here, we stay with the trade. Once we get this really high momentum push to the downside, and we see that price starts to pull back. Once that happens, it can continue higher sometimes, so we exit the trade here. From entry to exit here, we get 120 pips in our trade. So our profit is 120 pips or $1,200 if trading one standard lot. So that was our pinbar trading strategy. If you like that strategy, I invite you to click on the link below and you can get my course. This is a very special course just for the pinbar strategy, which will show you how to trade pinbars more effectively. So we'll go a little bit deeper into pinbar strategy and how to use it under different circumstances in this course. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe below. I'll see you next time.
If you want consistency in your trading, we invite you to join our daily market analysis calls, where we provide the levels to find the best entries and targets on an intraday basis. For a one-week free trial, please visit www.tradingwithvenus.com. Thanks for joining us today. With much gratitude, your show host, Raman Gill.